a few of us down to your house tonight at midnight. Make sure you are asleep in your beds, and so are your servants. Do not leave your beds. I want you to leave all your money, but more important, all your jewelry, in big thalis, in big stainless steel plates, in the middle of your room. We will, and unlock your door, of course, and we will come in, and we will take what is there. Now remember, do not even think of coming out of your beds. And he was so bold and so fearful that everybody would agree. And so it happened that a message came to one particular village, to the richest man in the village, who had a wife called Parvati. That was the name of the wife of the richest man in that village. Parvati. That was it. So the message came. You remember the message? At midnight, stay in
bed.
Leave all your
clothes
and money in a plate.
Okay.
And leave your door
unlocked.
Open or unlocked. And we will come and take what we need. But you must stay in
bed.
Parvati Bai's husband, I'm not going to let them get away with this. I'm going to round up my friends and we will wait for this bandit chief and his men at the edge of the village. Parvati Bai, she was wise, and she said to her husband, "But husband, these bandits, they are experts in their field. You are a landowner. I don't think you or your friends can possibly match them." Do you think the husband listened to his wife?
No.
No. Don't worry, I'll take care of it. And so that morning, he went around to all his friends, those who would agree. And in the early evening, they went and rode and waited for the bandit chief and his men. But what about his wife, Parvati Bai? She had another idea. She instructed her servants to make the best meal fit for royalty. And the servants, they got to work, oh my goodness. And not long after, those smells from the kitchen, oh, the curries, the puris, which are flatbread, which is dipped in oil, cooked in oil, all those smells of the pakoras, those fritters, oh, it was heavenly. And what did she then do? She put on her best silk sari, as though she was going to a wedding. And she got all her jewelry, she took off all her jewelry and put it in that plate. She left one item of jewelry on herself, and that was her marriage chain. Now here in Singapore, when people get married, they exchange rings. In India, well, they do that now too, but this is very important. It's a marriage chain. So she had a beautiful silk sari and a marriage chain. She did not go to bed. At midnight, she heard the horses. She heard the bandit chief and his men riding up, dismount, come to the door, and she had the door wide open, and in true Indian fashion, she said, "Namaste. Namaste, Bhai. Bhai means brother." And the bandit chief, he was shocked. Never in his life had he experienced anybody greeting him at midnight. with a greeting to say namaste and welcome. Brother, he was so shocked, he didn't know what to say. And she took the opportunity to say, my brother, you have come from a far away and you are dusty and I have prepared food for you. Please, have you and your men wash your hands and your feet and come in. He was so stunned, he obeyed. And he instructed his men to do the same. And they came in, and oh my goodness, on leaves spread out on the floor were the most delicious items of food you can ever imagine. And the bandit chief and the men, they sat on the floor because that's how you eat in those days. And in some homes in India, people sit on the floor, they have a plate, and they ate and they ate and they ate. And Parvati by herself, she said, oh please, have some more, you must be so hungry. Here, have some laddu, those sweet round balls. Have some puri, have some curry. Oh. She fed them herself. She served them herself. And when their tummies were full, and then she said, pointing to that plate with all the jewelry and some money, she said, my brother, please, you have eaten, and please, take what you have come for. But I urge you, please, do not take my marriage chain, because this is the most precious bond between me and my husband. The bandit chief stood up, he bowed very low, and as he looked up, there were tears in his eyes, and he said, nobody has called me by brother in a long time. I have eaten your salt. And as such, you are now my sister. And I promise that I will not harm you or your family or the rest of the village ever again, because now you are my sister. And with that, he left. And as he left with his men, he remembered to untie her husband and his friends at the edge of the village. And this is how Parvati sent her family and herself from the family.